Good morning, students. In this today's class, we will see about a topic on antenatal exercise. Exercise during pregnancy has benefit not just on expectant mothers, but also for their growing babies. Healthcare says that antenatal exercise can relieve back pain, get women ready for labor by improving the muscle strength and flexibility and improve energy levels. And this will be best to continue with the familiar activities rather than begin a new types of exercise, and then the woman would listen to her body when exercise and stop if she feels uncomfortable, fatigue or unwell. Definition: exercise involves the physical and mental ability to participate in carry out better functions of body throughout the pregnancy. Purpose of antenatal exercise include: antenatal exercise aims at preventing low back pain and enhancing physical and psychological preparation for delivery by means of joint stretching and muscle strengthening. Guidelines: breathe smoothly, work gradually according to the capability, work twice or thrice a day and repeat each set of movements 10 times in every session. Antenatal exercise may begin when the pregnancy reaches 16 to 20 weeks. Physiotherapists may make modification to the exercise according to the physical conditions. And maintain adequate fluid intake, warm up slowly using stretching exercise, but avoid overstretching to prevent injury to the ligaments. Avoid jerking or bouncing exercise. Be careful of loose throw drugs that could slip and cause injuries. Exercise on regular basis. After the first trimester, avoid exercise that requires supine position. Goals of antenatal care include: antenatal exercise include to reduce the painful and mortality and morbidity, to improve the physical and mental health of the woman and the child, to prepare the woman for labor, lactation, care of her infant, to detect early and treat properly complicated conditions. The purpose of antenatal exercise include to develop a good posture, to reduce constipation and insomnia, to alleviate discomfort, postural backache and fatigue, to ensure good muscle tone and strength, pelvic support, to develop good breathing habits, ensure good oxygen supply to the fetus, to prevent circulatory stasis in lower extremity, promote circulation, lessen the possibility of venous thrombosis. Contraindications: vaginal bleeding, severe anemia, history of preterm labor, extreme over or underweight, hypertension, heart, lung, thyroid diseases. The first trimester exercise include deep breathing exercise, relaxation exercise, postural correction, core muscle strengthening, pelvic bridging, tilting, rolling, alternative arm and leg exercise, Kegel exercise. Second trimester exercise include deep breathing exercises, relaxation technique, stretching calf and hamstring, gluteus isometrics, quadriceps isometrics, low back stretch, walk, labor education. Third trimester include stretching, squatting, Kegel exercise, walking for 30 to 40 minutes, tailor sitting. The first one is the pelvic floor exercise, or otherwise we commonly call it as a Kegel exercise. Sit on a chair with your back against the seat back. Tightens the vaginal, urethra, anal muscle as if trying to withhold urination or defecation. This can be do this exercise in standing position also. Please keep in mind that pelvic floor exercise enhances the control and support of pelvic floor muscles. It helps to prepare childbirth and prevents uterine prolapse, urinary incontinence and hemorrhoids. Back and abdominal exercise. Sit on a chair with your back against the seat back. Breathe normally. Tighten the abdomen and then press the pelvis downwards to flatten low back against the seat back. Hold for 5 seconds and relax. This exercise helps by correcting the low back and pelvic posture. It strengthens the abdominal muscle and prevents backache. Angle exercise. Sit on a chair with your back against your seat back. Start with one angle and turn foot upwards and downwards. Each up and down is counted as one time. Repeat for 10 times. Repeat angle to draw inward and outward circle. Each circular movement counted as one time. Repeat the same stem for the other angle also. Angle exercise helps to reduce leg swelling and varicose vein, thus alleviation the problems of leg cramps. Lower limb exercise. This exercise enhances the flexibility and strength of inner thighs and pelvic muscles. It helps to accommodate the delivery position and prevent thigh spasm during delivery. Sit on a table, low chair against a wall and spread the thighs sideways. Hold it for 5 seconds and then relax. It is suitable for pregnant women with tight thighs and not suitable for those who have pain over the pubic bone. LAMSA breathing is a breathing technique based on the idea that controlled breathing can enhance relaxation and decrease the perception of pain. Some of the importance of techniques for controlled breathing include slow deep breathing, maintaining a rhythm, breathing through the mouth or nose, keeping the eyes open or closed, focusing on one simple physical item, just photograph or the partner's picture. Those who support using LAMAIS suggest that breathing is just a part of LAMAIS method. LAMAIS is a full program for building confidence and keeping things in a symbol for a safe, healthy birth. Some of the labor comfort strategies recommend to make breathing techniques like changing the positions, moving, slow dancing, massaging. During the first stage of labor, start with a slow deep breath as the contractions start, then slowly breathe out, releasing all physical tension from the head to toes. This is often referred to as an organized breath. Slowly inhale through the nose and then pause. Then exhale through the mouth. Each time exhale, focus on relaxing on different body parts. During active labor, start with organized breath. Breathe in through the nose and out through the mouth. Keep the breathing as slow as possible, but speed it up when the intensity of contraction increases. Relax the shoulders. As the contraction peaks and the breathing rate increases, switch to light breathing, both in and out through the mouth, about one breath per second. Intensity of contraction increases, decreases, slow the breathing and go back to breathing. During the second stage of labor, focus mind and body, baby moving down and out, breathe slowly, guided by each contraction, adjust your breathing for comfort, when feel the end need to push, take a deep breath, slowly release it while bear down. When the contraction over, relax and take two calming breaths. Women who are most active prior to the pregnancy reduce their exercise level but continue to be on the most active during the pregnancy to overcoming the problems of getting risk diurnal exercise. Most powerful to a pregnant women might benefit from intensified diurnal advice. Four effective breathing exercises during pregnancy include, first is abdominal breathing. Lie down with the back with the ground and knees bent. During later stage of pregnancy, try lying on the side, lying position. Get a cushion to make it more comfortable. Now place the right hand on the abdomen and left hand on the chest. Breathe in through the nose. Woman will feel the abdomen push the hand up. The chest should be still during this process. Next, breathe out. Woman will feel her belly deflating when she exhales. Second type is counting breath. When woman count her breaths, she can help her body and mind relax. It is a great exercise and will come handy for the during labor. Lie with your back on the floor. Place one hand on the abdomen while other rest on her chest. Breathe in deeply to count of 5. Hold the breath for a count of 8. Now breathe out slowly to the count of 9. Try to push all air out of the lungs as she breathes out. Simultaneously, try and relax the body. Third is roll breathing. Roll breathing allows to use lungs to its optimum capacity. It makes helps to get the tune with her breathing pattern rhythm. This is one particular breathing exercise during pregnancy which offers a great way to relax the achy muscles. Begin as she did the abdominal breathing exercise, supine with one hand on the abdomen, other hand on the chest, bend her knees, repeat deep breathing for 8 to 10 breathing cycle. If she pay attention, she'll notice that her abdomen will rise and her fall back while she just rises, almost like a rolling wave. As she breathe out, make the whooshing sound as both her hands go down. And the fourth one is a type of yoga breathing. This best yogic exercise to try Ujjayi breathing. When maximize her body's energy level with this particular yogic breathing exercise. Breathe in and out deeply through the nose. Keep the mouth closed throughout. As she breathe in, the air will take a hissy noise. As she breathe out, constrict her throat and make the sound of an ocean. Benefits of antenatal examination. As the fetus grows, body require more oxygen to function at its optimum. Fetus too needs adequate oxygen to grow properly. Shallow breathing is not sufficient to provide body with ample oxygen. But with this breathing exercise, the body will get oxygen it needs. Second, anxiety and stress are the part of all pregnancy experience. With breathing exercise, can stay calm and de-stress. Third, the deep breath provide body with more oxygen, this in turn provides the relief from achy joints and muscle. And one thing most pregnant women dread is labor. But if the woman practices breathing exercise regularly, labor won't be such a huge battle. It will be allow her to manage her contractions and labor pain better. Most importantly, this exercise will help her to stay present during pregnancy and labor. They will allow her to enjoy miracle that is the childbirth. Thank you. Thank you for listening. If you have any comments or suggestions, please let